Okay, it's time for me to make my cream reduction. This is only going to get three things in it. So let's go ahead and get this up to medium. I'm going to put this entire quart of heavy cream in here. I'm going to shake that up. This was pretty expensive. That was almost $10 there for a quart. But that's the way things are nowadays. So we'll just dump that right in there. And the other thing we're going to be putting in is garlic. So I'm going to take probably two of the small cloves and quickly mince them up the same way that Martin Yan of Yan Can Cook would do, if anybody has saw that. And we're going to put some thyme in, and unfortunately I grabbed ground thyme. So I don't guess that'll make any difference, but I wanted whole thyme. So let's go ahead and mince up some garlic. So I've got two cloves of garlic, and we're going to mince these up just like Martin Yan would do. If you've ever seen Yan Can Cook, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I need to sharpen my knife. Not for this particular job, but I'll be cutting some stuff up here in a bit, including some chicken. But the way Martin Yan will mince up garlic is just like that. And look at that, perfectly minced up. So now we can drop this in to the pan, and now we need to do the other one. Yeah, whatever he says. So that's it. Garlic is all minced up, and that is powerful. Boy, I can really smell that garlic. It's going to be strong. And I think I'm going to do one more small one as well. So we'll grab one more, the smallest one I can find. Yeah. And there we go. There we go. So we'll let this start to come up to temperature. Sprinkle some thyme in there. And then we want this to boil for a while. We don't want it to boil, not heavily, but we want it to boil, and that's what's going to start to reduce it. So here I've got my roux that I made yesterday. I've had it sitting out all morning, so it's kind of room temperature. It'll be a lot easier to deal with like that. So I've turned my heat up much higher. That means I'm going to have to really pay attention to this. Cream will burn pretty easily, and I do not want to scorch the bottom of this stainless steel pot, because I want to use this to store it in. And I could easily have made this in the cast iron easily, and it would probably be at less chance of burning, because it's in a big thick pot where this is going to be pretty thin. But you can do it if you just pay attention to it and don't. We just want to bring it up to a boil, and it's already getting pretty warm there. So let's take and sprinkle in. Oh boy, that's probably enough thyme right there. Yeah. So anyway, we'll keep an eye on this, and we'll bring this to a boil, then we'll turn it down so it just sits there and boils and reduces down a little bit before we add our roux. Oh, it was good that I was paying attention, because that thing almost boiled completely over. It would flow clear out of that if I hadn't pulled it off the heat. So let's definitely turn it down now. And you can see it's boiling, but we're gonna watch it, because it will foam up and just come completely out of there and make one heck of a mess all over my stove. And now we gotta pull it off again. Yeah, it's gonna take a little bit. And for about the fourth time, that has tried to overflow on me. I've got it turned down. This is the reason why professional chefs prefer to cook on open flame. Because as soon as you turn that down, it's down. But as far as a stove like this is concerned, you turn it down, it's going to take forever for that burner to cool down to where you want it at. I've got it at medium low right now. And as long as I'm sitting here stirring it, as the temperature's dropping, it's going to behave itself. But I need to keep an eye on that. I want that to just turn over just like that. And hopefully it's going to behave and not make a giant mess all over my stovetop. Okay, finally, after a minute or so, that thing has cooled down enough that my cream sauce, my cream reduction, is going to behave itself. And I forgot to put one item in here, and that's a little bit of chicken stock. So I'm going to use one of these bouillon cubes. That's the only chicken stock I got. I almost forgot to put that in there, but it's pretty important. Won't add any salt or pepper to this cream reduction, because as far as I'm concerned, it's plenty salty, just like that. So, I am certainly no expert on cream or Alfredo or Béchamel, as it's called in Europe. Heavy cream is not something, cream sauces are not something that I really care a whole lot for. I love a good country gravy, a white gravy, a sausage gravy, which however you want to call it, and I do make that during the winter, biscuits and gravy and sausage and all the rest. But to me, Alfredo is just, it's too rich for me. I do like it, but it's not something I'm going to have a lot. So, and there's a lot of ways to make. This is the way that we made the cream reduction there in the kitchen. And unless I'm forgetting something, and I don't think I am. I need to give this a little taste test here. Might have to add some more garlic, but so I try to stay away from this product because it is fattening, it is cream. But there's a lot of ways to make Alfredo, and as I said, it's called Alfredo cream reduction or Béchamel. And we had some wise guy cooks there that would call it Béchamel, and they kind of changed it to beach camel. Bring the beach camel sauce over here, you know, that type of thing. Kind of kept things lively. Okay, let's taste this. That is really good. I can taste the garlic, the chicken broth. I can taste the thyme. So as this does reduce down, it's going to get more stronger. So I'm going to add nothing more to that. I'm going to turn that up just a hair. You might be able to see it is rolling over, and that's what we want it to be doing. Slowly starting to boil over. Well, it's been doing that for a while. I'm having to come over here and stir it every now and then. I can tell already that the bottom is not tacking up, which means it's not starting to scorch on the bottom. It has a wonderful Alfredo smell. Wonderful. But this is going to be so fattening, so terribly fattening. It's going to be good on a Cajun linguine and whatever else I'm probably just going to keep having Cajun linguines for a while. I'm not going to be having that much. This is going to be kind of a small one today because this is lunchtime. I'm really not all that hungry, but I do need to eat. So that's coming along nicely. We're just going to let that do its thing and reduce, and meanwhile, let's say this cream reduction is really close to adding in just a little bit of that roux. I'm going to let it go a little bit longer. It is working out perfectly. We've got to see what we got going on over here. That is reducing down nicely. I'm gonna let it go a little bit longer. I need to get this cream reduction out of the way. And I think it's good. Let's do a taste test on this. And we'll prepare to start putting in some of that roux. Oh, that tastes exactly like what it's supposed to. That's cream reduction there. So we need to put in a little bit of Parmesan. But let's get some roux in there. So see how thick that's gonna come out. That roux didn't really do much. But honestly, I think it's just about perfect right now. Now I can feel it tightening up a little bit, just slightly. We're good. We don't need any more roux. Now, of course, once I put this in the fridge and let it sit overnight, things might change. When I go to reheat this up, it could start to break, or it may need thin down, which will just take some milk. Oh, that's perfect, right there. Okay, I'm gonna snap that off and find a place to store this. Put that down first so I don't burn my counter. Okay, I forgot to mix any Parmesan in there. I just bought this. Winco did not have wheeled Parmesan. I prefer to grate up my own, but if they don't have the product, they just don't have it. So let's just sprinkle some in there, and it's probably going to be about that much. Alright. And then this, of course, has cooled down a little bit. You really don't want to milk it or melt it in there, but it's going to melt. It's still hot enough to melt. So that's good right there. We'll give that a taste here in a bit.